Hi, it's Dr. Joe Galati, and I wanted to give everybody an update on the latest breakthroughs in the treatment for hepatitis C. Late last week, Bristol-Myers Squibb received FDA approval on one of their medications called Daclatasvir. Now, this is a drug that will be combined with Sofosbuvir, which is a drug made by Gilead, already FDA approved. But this drug has received FDA approval specifically for genotype 3 patients. This is one of the more difficult subpopulations of patients to treat, the genotype 3. And the good news is that now we have what appears to be an effective treatment for this group of patients, which is now emerging as a group of patients that are more risk for complications such as cirrhosis and the development of cancer. And so with the release and approval of Daclatasvir by Bristol-Myers Squibb, in addition, you'll have to purchase Sofosbuvir. They're not together. They're two separate medications. This is very good news for specifically patients that have genotype 3 hepatitis C. Now, the results on how well they did. If you are a naive patient, never treated before, genotype 3, you have about a 90% SVR, sustained virologic response, at 12 weeks, after you complete 12 weeks of treatment. If you have evidence that you've been treated before, the SVR drops down a little bit to 86%. Now, if you do not have cirrhosis, the SVR or cure rate will be as high as 96%. That is absolutely quite fantastic. Unfortunately, if you do have evidence of cirrhosis, the research shows that your response rate will be about 63%, which is not all that great considering all of the new drugs we have. So the group that has cirrhosis is the most at risk for having the lowest response rate. Now, if you're keeping track of all the medicines that have been released so far, this new era of direct acting antiviral agents, we already have Harvoni, which is a combination of Ledifosfir and Sofosbuvir, one tablet, one pill, two drugs in one tablet. We have the Viekira Pac, which is a total of four medicines in that combination. Then we have Sofosbuvir, which can be given with combination of other drugs or ribavirin, as well as simeprevir, which was released well over a year ago. So now what is happening, we are evolving into the treatment of hepatitis C depending on what genotype you are, what subclass of the hepatitis C virus you have will dictate what medication you will receive or should receive. Then we have, do you have cirrhosis or no cirrhosis? And so what's happening is the medications are becoming more and more tailored to your specific situation. We could then have a whole different discussion as to whether or not somebody has advanced cirrhosis, they are waiting for a transplant, or they've had a liver transplant, if they are co-infected with HIV, and even more data is being specific on certain resistance or mutations that you may have with the virus, that certain drugs will work better. And even certainly a lot of research is looking as far as whether you're Caucasian, African-American, Hispanic, Latino, etc. So from where we were several years ago, basically one size fit all with the medications, we're now getting into much more specific therapies. And with the release of Daclatasvir with combination of Sofosbuvir, we are now channeling specifically for the genotype 3 patient. That's all that it is approved for right now. So if you have hepatitis C, genotype 3, you certainly would want to talk to your physician or hepatologist with regard to this new combination. Anyway, hope you enjoy this video and you're able to use it to your advantage. There's more information on our website, texasliver.com. Check us out. And of course, if you have any questions, all of us here at Liver Specialists of Texas are able to handle your calls and concerns, and we're happy to help you out. Have a good day. Continue to watch our videos and look at our website, and continued good health.